Demonstrators on both sides of Snyder versus Phelps are outside the nation's highest court. The case could prove to be the biggest test ever of the First Amendment. The U.S. Supreme Court will consider whether the Westboro Baptist Church should be punished for its hate-filled protests at soldier funerals, or if it's a right that should be protected. The Supreme Court battle is our top story on News 8 at noon. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Susan Shapiro. Al Snyder of York County took his battle to the nation's highest court this morning. It's a case some call the most important of the current court session. And News 8's Jerry Gish was in the courtroom for this morning's oral arguments. He joins us live from Washington with the story. Jerry?
Hi there, Susan. Quite a day today at the Supreme Court. And really, we had two different scenes here today. One outside, and you mentioned that. We had a large group, even hours before these oral arguments started, a large group of the public waiting to see if they could get in, and also a smaller group of protesters, as we've seen so many times, from the Westboro Baptist Church holding up signs. Inside, though, it was a packed courtroom, but very much subdued. A legal argument, discussions of laws surrounding privacy, public versus private figures, and of course, most importantly, the First Amendment, and how far does this go? This all involves the funeral back in 2006 of Lance Corporal Matthew Snyder, Al Snyder's son. It was protested by the Westboro Baptist Church, and the justices today clearly were looking for a line on free speech. Two of the justices literally said, "Help us find a line. We're looking for the line. How far can free speech go before it becomes harmful to someone, when it inflicts pain," which is what Al Snyder and his lawyers were arguing, that this protest involving the funeral inflicted pain on Al and his family. Now, again, once we got back outside after those arguments in court, this is what Al Snyder had to say about today.
There is a civilized way to express an opinion in America, but it does not involve intentionally inflicting emotional distress on others, intentionally harming a private citizen at a private funeral. It's not the constitutional right.
Again, I mentioned how we had two different scenes. Inside the court, we're so used to the Phelps family and the Westboro Baptist Church making outrageous comments. Well, inside the court, it was much, much different. Marjorie Phelps, one of the Phelps family members, made a legal argument, very much what you would expect to see in the Supreme Court. She was much different once she came outside of the court, once again using inflammatory language, saying the country is going to hell because of its acceptance of homosexuality, among other things. At one point, the Phelps family members, there was maybe four or five of them there at the microphones, broke into a version of the song Crazy Train by Ozzy Osbourne. So again, outside the court, much different than inside the court. However, both sides, both Al Snyder and his lawyers and the Phelps family, said they felt that things went very well inside the court for them. As far as a decision, could see that next spring, could be as late as next June, though. Reporting live at the Supreme Court in Washington, D.C., I'm Jerry Gish, News 8. Susan, back to you.
And Jerry, this was the first time for Elena Kagan, the justice. Was she on this case, or I know she's recused herself from some cases?
She actually is going to be recusing herself from many of the cases this session. This was not the case today. We had all of the justices up there. She spoke. In fact, every single one of the justices gave several questions today. We heard from every single one of them, Susan.
All right. Very good, Jerry. And I know you'll have more on this later today on News 8. Thanks
That's
very
right.
much.